The engine is at 80. Hi. In this video, I'm going to be talking something else about the fuel distributor. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. Okay, I know I promised you that I'm going to be talking about the ECU, but you must realize that the video is really huge and it is going to take me a long time to make it. But something else I wanted here to show you. And in this video we're going to be talking about the fuel distributor again. So, you know, in my last video I was showing you how to measure your pressures. Here I can post your link here up. And there I did it with two pressure gauges and I was a bit skeptical, let's say it like that. Skeptical because as I converted bars and kilogram per cubic or square centimeter, no matter. Then I got something that was astonishing. So it was something that the pressure difference between the two chambers on my car was 0.1 bar. And that was like, oh God, no wonder that my car is not accelerating as I would like it to do. And I decided to do that with the same pressure gauge. And that's not the only reason I wanted to make exactly this video. No, this is one more of the videos that is going to show you if there is something wrong with your fuel distributor or not. The second way how to check the fuel distributor. The first one would be to unscrew all the lines from your fuel distributor, then to start the fuel pump working while the engine is off, and then to see if there is any fuel going up from the distributor or leaking, let's say, leaking from the distributor. And the second check is with a pressure gauge. For this purpose, the pressure gauge is mandatory. And I will tell you why. If you don't have one, well, either find one, buy one, or you can do it other way. This video is for all of you that were scared from some mechanic, let's say it like that, that has no idea how Ke-Jetronic functions. And he says, ah, that's fuel distributor or who knows what. Who knows how they call that part, this poor part. Well, let me tell you, for the purpose of this video, or for the purpose of this check, let's say it like that, you will need to disconnect the EHA. That's a must. why does the EHA has to be disconnected? Because the EHA always changes the mixture. Once it is disconnected, then you will have that steady pressure difference you need for your car to operate, and that's why we have to disconnect the EHA. So nothing, no information from the sensors whether the car is warm or it's being warmed up or it's fully warm. No, it must be off. Afterwards, you will have to start the car and let it run until it is warm. As it is warm, then you will have to hook up your pressure gauge here. And to measure the system pressure. And then you note how much it is, 5.345. Afterwards, you get everything back, and then you hook up the pressure gauge here at the lower chamber. If you get the differential pressure you need to get, then nothing wrong with your fuel distributor, and literally nothing. The engine is at 80. And without this thing, you cannot do that. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.